Desperate Obama just showed up where Trump was and tried to take over as president blows up in his face. Retirement can be difficult for anyone, especially if you had a very taxing job in your former life. Many retirees report feeling unneeded or even irrelevant after they leave whatever high-powered job they poured their lives into. If you happen to hear of one of those retirees being former President Barack Obama, one could probably tell him that those adjectives are accurate. For 8 years, the United States languished under the rule of the Democratic puppet that is Barack Hussein Obama, sliding further and further from our former glory. This former president found it acceptable to apologize for everything that made America great, whether that be our free market, our immigration policies, our military, or even our level of cultural diversity. Everything that most Americans would consider the foundations of our great country, our former commander-in-chief railed against and attempted to undercut while in office, and America finally had enough of it. Even though he was elected for a second term, the middle-class citizen was finally shaken awake when we realized that our very ability to make a living was being taken away by this so-called Affordable Care Act that would either chain us to unbelievably steep premiums or fine us to death. And once we woke up to that truth, the darkness surrounding almost every policy that the Obama administration put into place became abundantly clear. So, when given the choice between an even more liberal and freedom-crushing choice, also known as Hillary Clinton, and the political outsider and standout businessman, Donald Trump, America decided to go with the one who had a reputation of knowing how to make a deal and, oh yeah, can balance a checkbook. Despite Hillary buying the votes of illegals and tampering with every possible election facet she could get her hands on, democracy still won out, and America got Donald Trump as president. This hasn't sat well with Obama, however, and he seems to be yearning for the days when all eyes were on him. According to the Independent Sentinel, he is actually shadowing the current president, going behind and doing what he has always done, apologize for our greatness. Acting like he is still president, Barack Obama is following President Trump's successful trip with one of his own, meeting with presidents, rehashing his alleged successes while abroad, all in an attempt to diminish Trump's overseas wins. In other words, he is a troll. Obama is on a three-country tour of India, China, France, meeting with presidents, talking about climate change, and acting the role of the pretender. It is sad when a has-been president is still attempting to bask in former glory and feels the need to shamelessly follow the current president around in Asia. He has gone where no president has gone before, and he looks very foolish. He is the Norma Desmond of politics. Norma Desmond was a character played by Gloria Swanson in the movie Sunset Boulevard. She is the dangerous and fading film star who ends up believing she is young, popular and beautiful when all the cameras are trained on her after she kills her young lover. Giving up being the most powerful person on the planet can be easy, but it is how this country was set up. You see, the term limit on president means that at least every 8 years somebody new gets to try and shake things up. While it is possible to have a great politician who wants to do what is best for the country, everyone knows that when re-election is at stake, a politician will do some crazy things. Just imagine what would happen if presidents never constantly ran a campaign, and never worried about the country as much as their own jobs? At least with this system, there is a sense of urgency, knowing that 8 years is the max. The former president has been following Trump in an attempt to reignite his former glory at President Trump's expense. In New Delhi, after meeting with the president of that country, without mentioning Trump's name, Obama said people must think before they tweet. He said he sees people getting in trouble for their tweets, and says they should follow the old advice of thinking before you speak, think before you tweet, Obama said. Same principle. He is very petty. The fading politician also met with President Xi of China, who praised him for the improved relations between the two countries. Lots of photos were taken, all were extremely flattering. Now here is the good part. Fox Business News host Lou Dobbs said that Obama should be arrested and forcefully brought back to the United States by U.S. Marshals if he keeps following Trump around. Now that would be something. Watch. Obama's attempts to draw the spotlight are transparently self-serving, considering what America has voiced we want to be done by our president. While many did want another Democrat in office, many also wanted a Republican when Obama was in power, but we waited our turn, and you didn't see Bush running around, pretending he was still making decisions after he left office. So if in your daily activities, you happen to run into former President Obama, please let him know it is time to hang up the presidential hat and fade into obscurity. Weary over it, he needs to be too.